My first question is, before we look at this photo, Joan.
Yeah.
I'm going back to the toilet stuff.
Really? Yeah.
Because you've said something, and I thought if I don't ask this, we're gonna miss it.
Yeah.
Did you say something about in the past? I don't know if this is in your lifetime or whether you just knew about it, but people used to empty the toilet.
Yes, the night soil men, they called them.
Can you remember night soil men or?
No.
But
no.
You know that they
were, yes, where it was, where the dustbin was. We called it dustbin shed. They used it to put the dustbins in it afterwards when they'd got proper toilets at the bottom of the yard.
Okay, so what was the toilets like when there was night soil men? I mean,
I've no idea because I never saw them.
Oh, but you think?
I think that must have been in what we call the dustbin shed.
Okay, so you think that at some time you would go to the toilet in the dustbin shed, which probably was just a hole.
Yeah, a wooden seat, all wood, like a box, like a chest sort of across with a hole in.
Right, okay. And then night soil men would come. So you do all your you do all your things in the day, or you probably have a chamber pot at night.
Yes, that's it.
Put it in the toilet.
Yeah.
And then it was never flushed, but somebody came around at night.
And emptied them. Yes.
Called the night soil men.
Yes.
How would you even know that that existed, do you think? Is it just...
Well, I've heard of it. You know, so
it's not...
read about it, could have done.
Okay, so it's not in your lifetime, as far as you can remember, that happened?
No.
There was a time where there was men walking around people's houses at night, emptying the toilets.
Yeah.
Probably getting paid for doing that.
Oh, yeah, yes.
Okay.
Well, they got paid a bit extra or not, I don't know.
And maybe they... Where do you think they put the...
Whether they put it on the land or not, I don't know.
Right, okay. I wonder if they put it in pigsties. I wonder if pigs...
Yeah.
Like stuff like that.
I don't know.
So that's... I've never, ever heard of that.
Haven't you?
Ever.
No.
And it's unbelievable to me that that could actually take place.
Yeah.
But that's a connection you've got that...
Yeah.
Maybe somebody, if they watch this, will say, I know exactly what she's talking about.
Yes.
And make a comment.
Yeah.
And just one more thing, just before we go on to this picture, Joan. I've come here today and the first thing we were talking about was the floods.
Yes.
Wasn't it? And think they're the worst floods we've had in Retford.
Yes, that I remember.
That you remember.
Yes.
The last time that there was floods as bad as this in my lifetime, I think it was about 2007.
Yeah.
And I might be guessing a bit there, I might be out a few years, but I took photos back then.
Yes.
Of the River Idle, off the bridges.
Yeah.
And it wasn't as bad as it was this time.
No.
So we've got some real bad floods, and so I took some drone pictures. So although that's very current and up to date, I'll probably add a few pictures in this video. Because in the future.
yes.
It might be a bit of history, mightn't it?
Yes.
Anyway, apart from that, Joan, we've got this lovely picture. And it's the wedding day. Whose wedding is it, Joan?
Bessie May Allen.
And what relation is she to you?
Auntie.
So she's your mum's...
sister.
Okay, and who's she marrying?
Jack Roberts. Jack Lithley Roberts.
Okay, and...
He was a flight sergeant, I think.
And where's this... Where is this picture?
It's taken, it's all right. It's only my washing machine.
All right, I'll just shut the door.
It won't shut. It's in the garden of East Retford Vicarage, St Swithin's Church Vicarage.
Which is no longer there, is it?
No, it's no longer there. I think it was a doctor's when it was, after it was demolished.
It's a doctor or a dentist, isn't it, on the corner of
Arlington Way.
And so we've got this beautiful picture, excuse me, and we can virtually name everybody on this picture, but
there's about four I don't know the names of.
The reason,
but they came from the air ministry, I believe.
Right, okay. I mean, the reason we're going to look at it a little bit is because it, I'm not sure, the marriage ended up a little bit weird, didn't it?
Well, it turned out he was already married and had got two boys.
Really?
In Wales, somewhere in Wales.
What was his name again?
Jack Lifney Roberts.
Do you know how they met?
Well, Auntie Bessie worked at the Air Ministry during the war, and he was at the Air Ministry. Worked there at Babbath. It was at Babbath.
How long did they stay together before they had to split up then? I mean, how did she find out?
Well, we always called in the morning when on the way to school or work, and she said, oh, the police have been round and they told me Jack's already married.
So she lived, so what?
She lived at 76 Grove Street.
With her
mother.
With her mother.
Our grandmother.
Your grandmother.
Yeah. And she'd had a baby boy, David. He was a baby when it happened.
Oh, okay.
When she was told, yeah.
So, just let me get his name again. What's his name?
Jack, and I think it's L. Y-F-N-I, Lifney, Roberts.
Roberts. So what?
He was Welsh.
And who's your auntie called again?
Bessie May.
So did Bessie May and Jack, did they live at...
They were at 76 Grove Street.
They lived there for a while, did they?
Yeah.
So... But the child, David.
Yeah.
How old was he when Bessie May found out? Do you think was he?
Oh, he was only probably. I don't know whether he'd be one or not.
So they did live together for a while,
well,
then, Jack and Bessie.
Because he worked with air ministry.
And then you went to school one morning, popped in at your grandma's and they told you that the police had been and said he was married.
Yeah.
Do you think a man who does that at that time, do you think he would have gone to prison for that? Or?
Yes, he would. But we found out that as there was three children involved, it wasn't sent to prison because it said it would cause too much hardship, and he contributed to David's maintenance, you know, till David was old enough to start work, I suppose. But because Jean and I used to, after, because Auntie Bessie was at work, she had to go work, she worked at Rubber Works then. And we had to go and collect the maintenance money from courthouse for her, because she was at work during office hours. So we used to go and collect the money.
Uh-oh.
And it paid right up to, well, whatever age it was that David was working, yeah. And sadly, years later, I mean, then he worked at power station when they were building power station.
David did.
Yeah, and he died at Port Maddock in Wales. And I keep thinking, oh, land of my fathers. There's a song, Land of My Fathers. It's a Welsh song.
Oh,
you say, because his father was Welsh, came from somewhere in Wales.
Did Jack come from somewhere in Wales?
Yeah.
Do you think Bessie May ever saw Jack again after that?
Don't think so.
Just never saw him?
No.
Just brought David up?
If anybody had... There's one or two people who knew him who had seen him, yeah. Because he was at Bawtry Hall, working at Bawtry Hall.
What year did they get married?
1947. I think it was.
1947?
Yeah.
Right, okay. And do you think Jack went to live back with his wife?
No, he was still... whether he was in lodgings or what, I don't know, but he worked at Bawtry Hall, that's all we knew.
Do you know if they got divorced? I mean, I don't know how that works. Do you get divorced?
Oh, yes, they'd have to, yes, they would have to, because in later years she married again. She got married.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So, where did David grow up then, locally, you know, when he was after...
Oh, Retford, he lived at 76 Grove Street.
Did he?
And then they moved to George Street after gasworks explosion. And they were out, went to Thrumpton Lane. Number 64, I think it was, Thrumpton Lane, yes.
But that wasn't just Bessie May and David, it was your grandma as well, wasn't it?
Yes.
So your grandma, Bessie May and David...
lived at Thrumpton Lane was the last place.
And did you say Bessie May actually got married again at some point?
Yes, she did, yes.
And can you remember who she got married to?
Bert Mellers.
Bert Mellers?
M-E-L-L-E-R-S. He lived on next street now, is it Thomas Street?
Yeah, well,
somewhere in that area, one of those streets, yeah.
Alright, okay.
And she worked at Rubber Works then.
What was Bert Mellers' job, do you know?
He worked for Mr. Budge.
Oh, okay.
Some of the time that we knew him, yes.
So you know your grandma, yes. Did she...
She died at Thrumpton Lane.
She died at Thrumpton Lane,
yes.
Wow.
Yes, she was she in her 80s, yeah. She was buried at Oldsall Churchyard.
And Bessie May, did she die? Where did she die?
Well, she was at... Conway Gardens.
She ended up at Conway Gardens,
yes.
Did she?
And then she had a fall and was in St Saviour's and then moved to West Villa. And she died at West Villa.
Right, okay. So, did she have do you think, because I know you was only young, but do you think she might have had a choice whether she could have stayed with Jack, because she's obviously found out this devastating news. But she possibly could have stayed with him, but she might have been so hurt.
Yeah.
You wouldn't really know,
no,
being a child, what decisions she was making. The reasons she was making decisions at the time.
No.
Okay, well, let's have a look at the photo then. So number one, I think, is your dad.
That's right, Harry Elston.
Who's number two?
That is Barbara Allwood. As a child, yeah.
And who's Barbara Allwood?
That's her brother Edward. And that's the family who have had the butcher's shop at Ellerton, the pork butcher's shop.
What, Barbara and Edward Allwood?
Yeah.
Had the butcher shop that lived...
I think Edward eventually had it, but there was... Lily Allwood, who and her husband had it, it's sort of been a family business.
The butcher shop at Allerton? And,
yes, Allwood.
And what relationship to you with those two?
It'd be cousins so many times removed or something.
Is there mum and dad on there then?
There's the mum at number 22.
Oh, yeah.
Peeping over Jack's shoulder, that's it, yeah.
All right, well, if we just carry on from them to number four. Is that your sister?
Yes, that's right.
And number five's you.
Yes.
And as usual, you look like you're dressed identically.
Yeah. Oh, yes, they were pale pink dresses with blue bows on and pink headdresses of roses, which Mum had made.
Really?
Yeah. And number six is Margaret, cousin Margaret.
Number six is cousin Margaret, is it?
Yeah.
And
and then there's two number sixes.
Oh, yeah, I do apologise.
Yeah, that's right. That is Barbara... Barbara... Oh, there's a mum at number 36, Barbara. Oh, dear. Oh, that's strange. I just can't think of it.
Well, it don't matter, because that might come
she
back.
She worked at Air Ministry. That's the one who took a part in excerpt from the play Gaslight.
What number, ladies, who are you talking about there?
The number 36.
Number 36? What's number 36's name, then?
Oh, sorry, no, it isn't 36, it's 35. A lady in a dark coloured dress or coat.
Oh, I see what you mean. It's 35. Right, so, number 35. Who is number 35 then?
Well, that's this little girl's mother.
Do you know her name? The lady at number 35?
Well, I did do. But it just won't come there.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah, it'll come short.
Did you say you know where she worked?
Yes, she worked at the Air Ministry. At Babbath, with my auntie, yeah.
Okay, so that's the little girl's mum.
Yeah.
Who's called Barbara?
Yes.
Okay, so her name might come in a few minutes then.
Yeah.
So, number seven then. Who's number seven?
Where are we? That is Anne Spencer. Her mother was a Welshman before she married. Yeah. But seven, that's Anne Welshman.
So Anne Spencer?
Yes.
Is her mother on there?
Yes, she is. A lady who's sort of she's moved ahead with a hat on. Number nine is her mother, Phyllis Spencer.
Oh, lovely. She's looking over her.
Yeah, she's talking to her, yeah.
That's Phyllis.
It's Phyllis Spencer, formerly Welshman.
Formerly
Welshman. And that's her husband, Frank Spencer, number 10. And he was a photographer.
Really, photographer?
So I knew it wasn't him who'd taken the photo because of these. Right. Yeah, and...
So did we get... So she's looking over at her daughter at number 7.
Yeah.
Who's called Anne.
Yeah.
But there's a number 8. Who's number...
Yes, that is Joan Woodward, the deaf and dumb girl, whose parents had Taylor's shop in Grove Street, next to my grandma's. After the Taylors had had it.
Is she... She's not on any VE pictures, is she?
Yes, she's on Richard Street one.
Is she?
Yeah.
Joan Woodward.
Yeah, and then they were, at that time, they were living on Caledonian Road. At Victory, Richard Street party.
Right, okay.
That's why she was invited and she used to come and play with us.
So she lived on Caledonian Road, but what connection did she have to that tailor's shop on?
Her parents had it, Charles Woodward.
Did they have it before they lived on Caledonian Road, or...?
No, it was after, I think, yeah.
Wow, so that would go up to number 10, so... Actually, I'll put number 11 right over somebody's face. Can you see who number 11 is?
No, 11, where are we? That's Mum.
Oh, sorry.
Yes, well, you can't tell who, in the hat.
Oh,
number 11.
That, of course it is. There's a smart lady next to her with a black hat on, number
12.
Yeah,
that's Emmy. We knew her as Emmy Rikes. I don't know whether that was a married name, but she was Emmy Randall. She was Derek Randall, the cricketer's auntie.
Oh.
And she lived on Queen Street. And she always used to get invited to my grandma's at Christmas.
Oh, right, so she's Christmas, Derek Randall's auntie.
Yeah.
Wow, I'm just trying to, 1947, so, and then one of her relatives, her sister or brother, had Derek Randall.
Randall, okay. 12.
Wow, that's brilliant, so.
Now then, I can't see number 13, but I can see my Auntie Betty. Hunter, Betty Allen,
do you mean
just behind Jean.
Yeah, okay, so that's
what Betty Allen.
Wow, you can only just see it, can't you?
Yes.
I think that must have been number 13, unless we come across it, but I forgot to put number 13 in.
Yeah, and well, it would blot her out, wouldn't it?
Yeah, that's probably why I didn't do it. So that's Betty Allen. Who's Betty Allen?
She married Uncle Harold.
Oh, she's Harold's wife, who's your mum's brother.
Yes, that's it.
Oh, brilliant.
And twin brother of Auntie Bessie.
Yes, got a twin, yeah. So we've got number 14 then, we've got a... Actually, we have got a number 13, I think that's the vicar. To the left, above your dad.
Oh, yes, that's it, yes, right.
Yeah. Is that the vicar?
Yeah, I've forgotten his name.
What about number 14 then?
That's Ernest Taylor, who used to have the shop next to my grandma's house on Grove Street.
Oh, so is that the deaf girl's dad then, or?
No, that's the deaf girl was Woodward. This is Mr. Taylor, Ernest Taylor.
Okay.
And his wife had died by then, Lizzie, because she's not on the picture, so.
Right, okay, so I've got a little, just so I'm not too confused. Ernest Taylor had the shop next to your grandma.
Yes.
But didn't you say that the deaf and dumb girl...
Yes, they did later on.
They had it later. Got you.
After Mr. Taylor had retired.
And did Mr. Taylor, is there any other... I mean, did he have a daughter or anything?
Yes, Ethel.
Is she on there, do you think?
No.
Okay.
Now, I think she'd be in the Ebsworth Hall seeing to the wedding breakfast, same as the another lady who...
Right, so they went, so because after the wedding they went to Ebsworth Hall.
Ebsworth Hall,
which is just at the back of the church, isn't it?
Yeah.
For the reception.
Yeah.
So, what about number 15? Can you tell...
Oh, that's Miss Swannock of Grove Street. There was a furniture shop next to dentist. Swannock's.
Yeah.
Edwin Swannock, I think it was.
Miss Swannock's.
Miss Swannock.
That furniture shop.
Yeah.
Where did you say for that furniture?
Grove Street.
It was on Grove Street, was it?
Yeah, next to Mr. I've forgotten his surname, the dentist.
Okay, so it was...
But when we were at school, it was Mr. Mackley who was the dentist there.
Really? And then, because Swannock's is up for Bridgegate.
No, no, this was Grove Street. This is... I don't know whether it's a different family of Swannocks, but there was Miss Swannock, because my grandma used to deliver milk there,
yeah. Well, they probably then moved up Grove Street, up Bridgegate,
Yes, but...
It must be the same.
Could have done, yeah.
Both furniture, aren't
that,
they?
Yeah.
So, okay, so that's Miss Swannock, so number 16.
That is Clarence Hunter from Clayworth.
Clarence Hunter? Clayworth.
Yeah. Elfield Farm, Clayworth.
17?
That's Ruth Bell, and she married Clarence Hunter. She's still alive. She's in St. Saviour's.
Really? Ruth who?
Hunter. She was Ruth Bell.
Bell?
Yes.
Ruth Bell in St. Saviour's.
Yeah, but it's she married Clarence Hunter.
And they were married, were they?
Yes. In 1953, because Jean was a bridesmaid.
Oh, married in 1953, that's worth noting.
Yeah.
And she's still alive?
Yes, at St. Saviour's. and she sends letters, and on her address, she put St. Saviour's Care Home, Leggett Lane, L-E-G-G-I-T.
Can you, number 18 then, can you work out who number 18 is?
That's Clarence Hunter's mother, Winifred Hunter.
Winifred.
Hunter, but she was Winifred Greenham before she was married, and her parents had the White Hart pub on Clayworth, the canal bridge.
Wow.
At the wedding, because I can remember being taken into the living area, and there was a lady there cooking chips on the fire in a big saucepan. I remember. It called Mrs. Hickman. She must have been the housekeeper or something like that.
What, at Clayworth?
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that's... So, number 19 then, who's number 19? Oh, 19, we've gone back to the left, next to your sister.
Oh, that is Grandad Goddard. That's William Vardy Goddard. And he was the father-in-law of Auntie Dahlia. She married his son George Goddard.
Right, so your Auntie Dahlia was she old?
No, she was Alan, formerly.
Yeah, Alan, yeah. Okay, so your Auntie Dahlia.
She was the middle one of the family.
She was Alan.
Yeah.
And ended up being Goddard.
Yeah.
Right, so number 20 then.
Is Mrs. Goddard Senior.
Mrs. Goddard.
Yeah. They lived at Worksop.
And who was their son? Who was their
son? Was George.
Is George?
George, who married Auntie Dahlia.
Is he?
Yes, he's number 27.
Oh, right, okay. So number 27 is
George Goddard.
George Goddard, and he's the one who married Dahlia, yeah?
Yes, that's it. And she's number 25 on the picture.
Number 25, let's have a look, number 25.
Oh. And a dark coloured hat.
Yeah, are you sure you've got the right one? So number 25, just next to the bride.
Yes, that's it, yeah.
That's
Roxana Dahlia Goddard, formerly Alan.
Right, so are we talking about Roxana Dahlia as in one of the 23, or are we talking Roxana Dahlia? She's got the same name, hasn't she?
Yes.
Is it your mum's sister?
Yes.
That's the Roxana Dahlia we're talking about.
Yeah.
The little girl who's in the garden.
Merrills. The name's Barbara Merrills.
Her daughter was called Barbara Merrills. Sorry.
Lady who could remember a name. She was Dorothy Merrills.
Tell me what number that was.
Dorothy Merrills now then, where is she? 35, I think.
Yes, 35.
Yes, that's Dorothy Merrills.
35.
Merrills, I think.
Dorothy Merrills.
Yeah.
And she's the mother of that little girl, isn't she?
Barbara, with the big... Oh, well, they both got McKay, haven't they? She's got Auntie Bessie's McKay, yeah.
Oh, dear. So, we was talking about... Oh, Dahlia. Yeah, so... Your Auntie Dahlia... It's Auntie Dahlia, isn't it? It's your sister.
Yeah.
Okay.
And... number...
just before you move on, Joan.
Oh, there's 24, isn't there? Where are we?
Yeah, well, just before we move on, yeah. Is 25 married to number 27?
Yes, that's okay. Right, that Dahlia and George.
And then, before we go up to 24, can you just tell me, can you see anything of number 26? There's number 26, and there's very little there.
That's my grandma, Mary May. You can just see a hat and half a bit of a face. And a bit of there were pink beads on that navy blue dress she's got on. It was, yeah.
Wow, so is that Mary May Allen?
Yes, I mean, she's on the, with the bride and groom on another picture.
Yeah, okay, I can't believe you can see that, but that is amazing.
Yes, I can, yes.
And did we, was we just going to number 24? What? Who's 24?
Oh, that is Miss Grindle, who lived on Woolpack Street and had the vegetable stall on Retford Market.
Wow.
I suppose it's Grindle.
Miss Grindle.
Yeah.
And 20, can we go to
23? 23, where are we?
22. So... that's above the bride, next to Miss Grindle.
Oh, oh yes. Yeah. Oh, that's Eva Warwick, a married name. She was Eva Tootle.
Eva Tootle and became Eva Warwick.
Yeah.
Okay, and then I think we have got... I'll tell you what, while we're there, just have a look at 36, just above her.
36, that is Miss Joan Spencer, who had the shop near the Turk's Head.
So
did baking and sold cakes and, you know,
yeah,
things like that.
Did that shop have a name?
Well, we just knew it as Joan Spencer's. And then Joan Kidney had it as a herb shop, a good health shop.
Did she, Joan Kidney?
Yeah. Before she moved to New Street and Carrollgate.
That corner there. That was. Joan Kidney. Did you say Joan Spencer had it first and then it was Joan Kidney?
Now that's two different ones. Joan Spencer had the shop next to Turk's Head.
Yeah, but and then that shop became...
Joan Dixon had it then. Well, she married Bernard Kidney. She was a Dixon, Joan Dixon.
Oh, and she married Bernard Kidney.
Kidney, yeah. Yeah, she was, Joan was in our class at school.
Joan Dixon was in your class at school?
School, yes.
As a little girl?
Yeah, and then she went, whether she went to the high school or Holcroft, I'm not sure which. But, I mean, we stayed at National School all the time and left at 14. Yeah.
And she married Bernard Kidney?
Kidney, yeah.
So does that mean that at some point, did they own a... Do you think there was like... oh, crumbs, what would you call it? An alcohol shop on the market square. Does that ring a bell?
No.
Oh, okay. I think, right, okay. I think there was a link somehow there.
Is there? Oh.
But I don't know. So, right, let's have a look where we got to. So, did we...
We got to Joan Spence, didn't we? Yeah.
Yes, it was number...
36.
Right, I want to just... cover.
Sorry, have we got, yeah, 36. Yeah.
Right, okay. So we've got 36. Can we jump down to 24? Who's 24?
Oh, that's Miss Grindle. We were just doing that, weren't we?
Oh, yeah, got Miss Grindle, 24. I've got a couple missing here, 21 and 22. So where are they?
Oh, 22, I found. Oh, 21. Now, 21 is a late. Lady with glasses on. And that's one of the ladies who was at the Air Ministry, I think. And also the one above her, number 30. Was it 30?
Oh, 33,
three,
I think.
Is it?
Yeah, 33.
And the one 32, I didn't know her name.
Right, okay, so
24, 32 and 33, don't know, they don't know the names. No. 34. I just know they're called a Joyce, and I think she married Desmond Woodward, who was number 42 behind her.
42.
At the back, he's the back row, 42.
Desmond
Woodward.
Woodward.
Whose parents had Taylor's shop.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Woodward.
So is he, now you've said Woodward, is he related to the deaf and dumb girl?
Yes. Their brother and sister.
So is he on the Richard Street photo?
No. No, there's only Joan on that one. Yeah.
Right, okay. So. 21 and 22, have we just had a look at them ones, so...
No, 22...
Yeah.
...is Auntie Lily Allwood, who had the butcher's shop at Allerton.
Right.
And her husband must have been deceased, because I never saw him. The one who had the butcher's shop, and then the son had it. The son is at the back, number 39, and they called him Evelyn.
They called the son Evelyn?
Yes.
And he's number 39?
39, yeah.
Evelyn...
Allwood.
Allwood.
Yeah.
When we say Allwood, these must be related to you then?
Yes. Right. Second cousins or something like that.
Yeah, so Allwoods were...
Butchers, shops.
Yeah, so somewhere along the lines, these Allwoods that we're talking about are part of the 23 children.
Children or descendants of them.
Got you.
Yeah.
Okay. And have we done number 21? I can't ever see 21 for some reason, but...
No, I haven't found it, 21. Now, my grandma appears, she could hardly see it.
Just say that again, Joan.
That's my grandma, sort of.
Has she
got... Oh, she's... No, she's 26.
26.
She can add, she's behind the...
oh, yeah, Mary May Allen.
Yes.
Mary May Allen was old, wasn't she?
Yes, that's right. Yes.
And she's one of the 20...
Three, yes.
Yeah, 23.
Yeah.
So those butchers at Ollerton.
Yeah. That's Auntie Lily. Yeah.
Right, okay.
And her son was Evelyn. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So it's, so Lily...
She lived to be a good age. And she moved... She used to live at Farley after they'd retired from the shop.
So Lily was probably Mary Allen's... Oh, no.
Sister-in-law.
Sister-in-law, yeah, that's it. So it must have been Mary Allen's brother.
Yeah.
Who married Lily, yeah. Got you. Okay, so my next number is, have we looked at 37? I made a note, where's 37?
37.
Top left. In the doorway, there's a 37.
That is George Mitchinson,
who had
the diamond wedding, and his wife Vina is number 31, just in front of him.
That's number 31, is it?
Yeah, it's a lady with glasses on.
Vina. 31. Is that the Brex Road wedding?
Yes, yes.
My goodness. And did you say that's them up there?
Yes.
So we've got them as young people at the wedding and on your walls.
Yes.
And why are they on the wall? What is that on the wall?
That was the diamond wedding. Anyway.
You don't know where that is taken?
It was at...
That one on the wall.
Well, I think it might have been Yorkshire Post, because there was a picture of them and saying the bridesmaids were... attending the diamond wedding anniversary. You see, there's my mum
and that other lady on that picture.
At Overton, yes.
My goodness.
Yeah.
And where is the picture taken, do you think? Is it just at the house?
Well, they lived at Doncaster at...
I see.
Or was it... Carhouse Road at Doncaster.
Really?
They lived, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Have we got... And did you say... So Vina's number 31.
Yeah.
Which I think we might have been looking for earlier. We found it. 31. I've 28 now then. Where's 28? I haven't got a name for number 28 yet. 28. Oh, so if you look back to the right...
Yeah.
At the top... Well, there's two rows, isn't there? So 28. Can you see it? She's...
Oh, yes. Oh, that's Mrs. Woodward.
Yeah.
Who had the shop after the tailor.
28. So we may have mentioned it. I just didn't have time
to
write it down.
No.
Woodward. This is Mrs. Woodward. Is this the same as...
Yeah, it is. And this...
Desmond and the little...
Yes. And... 28. And Charlie Woodward is number 30. Is it 30 or 30? It's just above Phyllis Welshman. He's at the back row on the right hand side.
Right, okay, so just give me what number was Phyllis?
Phyllis was number 9.
Oh, okay, so is it number 30, Charlie Welshman?
Woodward.
Is he number 30?
Yeah, I think it is 30.
Who is 29 then?
That's George Crooks.
Right, let's
from Kirk Street, the one who did the model of the Methodist Chapel. On Carrogate Bridge.
He was at...
George Crooks.
Wow.
And his wife... isn't on the picture, So I think she'd be in Debs herself seeing to the food.
And then what, so just tell me about George Crooks. Why did he make a model? Did he make a model before? Why did he make a model?
No idea.
And he's actually sat with somebody, isn't he?
With the vicar, yes, in the picture, the model.
So he made a model of the church that was on Carrollgate on the bridge.
Yeah, that later was the Cat's Cradle.
That became a Knights Club.
Yeah.
And then
Furniture, and then a carpet shop, I think it was.
Yeah, below, and I think, and then we used to go to the gym above there.
In the 90s,
it was Brackenbury. Barry's gym.
Was it?
Yeah, I might have said that wrong now. It's so long I've said Simon Brackenbury or whatever his name was.
I don't know.
It was a gym.
Oh, can't remember.
I wonder why he would make a model of that church.
Yes, I wonder.
Was he famous in any other way? I mean, did you just...
No, he worked, I think he worked at it was on Carrollgate. I know he suffered from asthma and used to, I think he used to go fishing a lot, and he took quite a lot of photos because my mum went to the auction sale of the contents of their house on Kirk Street after they both passed away, and she bought the photograph album, which I've got somewhere.
You've got his photograph album.
And there's even some photos of us in it.
No way. Yeah. And that's in here somewhere.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. And he had asthma, did he?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I wonder why he built that church as a model. Well, I mean, he wasn't even young in the picture.
No, it wasn't.
It must have just been a hobby.
It must have been. And Mum also bought a picture, which the original was painted by Millet, who was drowned when the Titanic went down. He was, an American artist, and they were coming from America to come to England when it sank.
What, the Titanic?
Like, yeah, 1912, that was. But Mum bought this picture, and it's one, it's called Between Two Fires. And there's a chap it looks like a Quaker, sat at the table, and there's women either side of him. And it's called Between Two Fires by Millet, Millais. Whether it's a print or just a copy, I don't know. But I've seen that picture is cropped up on various programmes very often.
Right. So the Titanic.
Yeah.
It's maiden voyage. Was from England.
Yeah.
To America.
Okay. Or was it from Ireland? Did it? I think Ireland was concerned, didn't it?
Yeah, yeah. But it wasn't from America to England, was it? It was going the other way.
Was it? Oh, I've forgotten which way, actually.
Yeah, I hope I'm right now. You never really have to think about it until someone says it. No. But anyway, I just thought, if someone would be watching this and thinking, no, it's this way.
Thank you.
But what you say? What do you say? Somebody was on the Titanic who drowned.
Who was an artist.
Who
belonged to what did they call them? There was three or four all lived together, artists.
Three or four artists lived together?
Yes.
And there was a little art group?
Yes. And they had a special name.
Right, okay.
That is somewhere at the back of my mind.
Okay, well, I'll just have to give that a bit of thought then. Just tell me the artist's name again. What did you say the artist
was? I think, was it John Millais, MILLAIS.
And he painted a picture called?
Between Two Fires.
Two Fires?
Yeah.
And who owned this picture?
Well, Mum bought it from the Crooks sale.
Can you just tell me the number again? Where's Mr...
Crooks, George Crooks, down then, where was he?
Is he number 29? Is that where we got to?
No, yes, that's right, yeah.
So George Crooks is the guy who painted, who made a model.
Yes, of the chapel or church, whatever, the Methodist.
On Cowgate Bridge. And when he died...
But it was after his wife. She was electrocuted while she was ironing one Monday afternoon.
Really?
And she was a friend of family, and she used to come to my grandma's at night and do embroidery, because my grandma did some beautiful embroidery, tablecloths and things. I've got some of her embroidery. And Mrs. Crooks was doing her ironing one Monday and got electrocuted. So there was an inquest, and of course coroner, got the evidence, got the iron, weighed it in our safe.
Put it in your safe?
In the safe at the office.
Yeah. Where did they live at the time? Where
at Kirk Street, number 9 Kirk Street.
Fucking heck. And did she die?
Yes.
As an old lady or as a...
She was retired. I don't know what she used to do.
George outlive her?
No, she outlived him.
And then she electrocuted herself.
Yeah.
Plugging the iron in her?
Well, it might even have been in light, you see.
Wow.
I don't know. But there was an inquest, yeah.
Dear me.
Yeah.
So that was... that proves how dangerous that was, doesn't it?
Yes, and I mean...
She could have had wet hands or something.
And I remembered about Mum to do with the iron. We had the flat irons, you see, and she used to have something that she hung on one of the bars on the coal fire, stood the iron up on end to heat the flat iron, as they called them. Yeah.
That's your Mum?
Yes.
She used electric iron.
Yes, when we'd got more electric plugs, you see, yeah. But, I mean, it was the flat irons, metal.
So when she died,
yeah.
Why would people be allowed to go into the house to buy things? How does that work?
Well, very often they used to sell the house and contents. If the people hadn't, there wasn't any descendants to take, you see, they didn't have any children, the Crookses. So, that was it. I know Mum went to two or three house sales and bought things.
That's quite, that's interesting that she bought photo albums.
Yes.
Because most people really don't care much about photos, do they?
No, you see, and then we found some of us on.
And then you've got them in here somewhere
a black photo album.
So we've got, because that's interesting, that, Joan, because we've got pictures of George Crooks. We know a bit about his life, hasn't he? Built a model.
Yeah.
You know where he worked.
Yeah.
Because the chemist, co-op chemist, you think?
Yeah.
He died before his wife.
Yeah.
And she died of electrocution.
Yes.
And then everyone went in their house and bought all the belongings.
Yeah.
Good grief.
Yes.
You have absolutely brought that picture to life. You know, yeah.
Yeah, and you'll see it, it's above the piano in the front room.
What is?
The Between Two Fires picture.
Sorry, that you've got that here?
Yes.
You
And when Dad was at his coronary, of course he was in a bed downstairs and we'd got the picture in here then, and he used to say, it always reminded of an undertaker watching him. Yeah, but he was 10 years after his daddy's coronary lived. So,
really?
But he was only 77, but really he was a gentleman. He was lovely.
Who was a gentleman?
My dad.
Your dad, yeah. Absolutely. Wow.
Happy Harry, he was known as.
And what was George Crook's wife called?
Fanny Crooks.
Fanny Crooks.
Yeah.
And is she on the picture?
No, she's not. So I think she must have been seen to the food.
Oh, that's a
helping,
shame.
Yeah.
George Crooks.
No, I haven't got a photo of her at all.
Have we got number 30 yet, Joan? Oh, number 30 is that guy. You can just see off his head. Above number 29. Above Phyllis, on the right-hand side.
Oh, 30, that's Charlie Woodward, who had the shop after the tailors.
Yes, okay, Charlie Woodward. And he is...
next to his wife at number 28.
What was his wife called?
I don't know.
Okay, don't know her name.
No.
And they owned the shop. So is Charlie Woodward the father?
Of Joan. Joan and Desmond.
Yeah, okay. But on your picture of the street, VE Day, there's only Joan there.
That's all, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So I'm still missing on my list at 32. Where's 32? Ah, 32.
And that's...
That's one of them ladies, isn't it?
It is, yes, at Ministry.
So 32 is Air Ministry. So can you just... We keep mentioning the Air Ministry. What is the Air Ministry?
Well, it was at Babbath. I don't know what they did. I think it must have been secret work because we never knew what my auntie did there, Auntie Bess.
So she... Auntie Bess...
Worked at Air Ministry. Before that, she'd worked at Miss Best's ladies' underwear shop on Carrogate. But then she must have been conscripted to Air Ministry.
And then...
At Babbage.
Where she met her husband.
Yes, that's it, yes.
Who had already been married.
Yes.
And then eventually she worked... Did you say Jenkins?
No, Rubberworks.
She worked at Rubberworks.
That's where they lived on Thrumpton Lane, yeah.
So the Air Ministry. Oh, yeah, okay. So we.
But
don't
I
really...
think the lady, number 32, she looks to me as though she might be in uniform.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I know there was one friend who used to be there called Mary Ellis. Whether that's her or not, I don't know.
So we're at 33, and we said the same thing. Where's number 33?
32.
Okay, I can't see 33. Let's have a look then.
I've got 34.
So just quickly then, so you think 32 is the Air Ministry?
Yeah.
Oh, 33 is right next to her. You can hardly see the three. She's to the right. She's the lady to the right, number 33. So we've got 32 is the Air Ministry lady.
Yeah.
And then to the right.
All I can see is 34 next.
She's in between 32 and 34.
Oh, number 40. That's Mavis Derney. She was Mavis Huff. She married Red Stern, he was number 38.
How do you spell the name?
Health,
H-O-U-G-H.
And she married Red Stern, he was at number 38.
And how do you spell his surname?
D-E-R-N-I-E. He was at the barber's, he had the barber's shop. Next to our office, yeah.
Oh, really?
And Mavis worked with Auntie Bessie at Miss Bess's shop, at the ladies' the underwear shop. And then she was in the ATS, and when she used to come home on leave, she used to call at my grandma's, and if we happened to be there, she used to be drilling us in the yard.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Who was that? Who did that?
Mavis.
She worked at work. What did you say? She was ATS?
Yes. She was in the ATS. And there is a photo of her in a folder, there was.
What, here?
Yes, you might come across it.
Oh, okay. So, Reg Durney... He had hairdressers next to your...
Office, yes.
Well, the library's on one side, isn't it?
Yeah, and it was the other side.
Right, okay.
And then there was Tim Taylor's fruiter's shop. So, and then the almshouses.
Oh, I've got you.
Sussex Hospital, rather, they called it, yeah.
So Reg Durney, was that the shop called that, Durney's or something?
Yeah, yes, I think so.
And just back to Mavis Hoff.
Yeah. Hoff. She had a brother called Roy, and I think he worked at Swanwick's furniture shop on Bridgegate then.
But did you say Mavis worked with your auntie?
Auntie Bessie. It's Miss Best's shop. Yeah.
Miss Best.
Yes, but it was Mrs. Easom, really, but it said M. Best above the shop.
Where was that shop?
Carrollgate, next to Percy Law's photographer's shop.
Right, okay, which we think is... Well, Percy Law's was upstairs.
No, he was downstairs.
Was he? What was upstairs?
Well, I think it was an insurance company. Because you went up some stairs that were further back in the... Because there's a room above where you walked to get into both shops.
We are talking about where the jeweller's shop is.
No, yes, that's it, yeah.
Yeah, okay. And that was Miss Best, and she sold...
A lady's underwear.
So...
Well, and then it was Maisie Payne had it.
Right, okay.
I don't know whether you remember seeing that name or not.
No, well, it rings a bell, so I'll have to look that up.
She was in the next class at school to us. And she lived on Trent Street then.
Who did it?
Maisie Payne, yeah.
Did she? What was her shop?
It was ladies' underwear. She was Maisie Briggs before she was married.
She was... When you say the next class to you at school, do you mean she was older or younger or something?
She was older, one year older than us, yeah.
Mavis Hoff, she worked in...
Miss Bess, yes.
But she was a member of the ATS?
Yes, she was...
During, in wartime?
Yes.
And she would come round to your grandma's? Yes,
because it was a big yard and drillers. Well, left, right, halt and all that, yeah.
Did she do that? Was that just all a bit of fun?
Yes, it was, yeah. Yes, oh, she was. She was, you know, you always had a good laugh with Mavis.
She was funny, was she?
Oh, yes, yeah, she was. Oh. And she told me that when she was working at the ladies' underwear shop, they used to have glass display cases. And for a joke, she got in one and laid down in it, and then a customer came in. I don't know what happened, but whether the customer said anything. I don't know. But she said that's what she'd done.
Hold on a minute. Whereabouts? Did she do that at...
At Miss Best Shop. So, in the glass showcase.
What, in the ladies' underwear shop? Yeah. She lied down in the glass. Not just in her underwear, did she?
No, but what she didn't say.
So she, what, was she pretending to be a dummy or something? Or?
Yeah, something like that. Oh, yeah. Yes, you can always have a good laugh with Mavis.
Oh, it's a shame we can't hear her laughing telling you jokes. All these wonderful things. And people that have gone.
Yeah.
And she was part of the ATS.
Yeah. So I don't know what she got up to there.
And, right, okay, so we'd...
40. Mavis oh, is, then we haven't got 39, have we?
Well...
Oh, have we? Evelyn.
Evelyn Allwood.
Yeah. Oh, and 41 is Uncle Harold.
Oh, right. Oh, Uncle Harold, yeah.
Yeah, he's 41.
What do you remember about Uncle Harold? Because I've got some them lovely pictures of him as an army person. Was he an officer or just a private?
Yeah, he was a... An AC2, I think, as they called it. But he was in the ground staff. He wasn't in an aeroplane. He was just ground staff, we knew. And he gave me that up there in between that shelf. That picture is something to do with the D-Day landings.
Do you mean that there, in that frame?
Yes, in that old frame,
It's got some writing on some
Yes. Oh. Pet Level, where that's somewhere near Dover, I think, that area, it says on it.
Uncle Harold, did he get married?
Yes, that's the one we were bridesmaids at Clayworth.
Okay, who did he marry?
He married Betsy Matilda Hunter.
Right, okay, Hunter. But they didn't have children, did they?
No.
And where did they live?
Clayworth. Yeah.
So, right, I just need to go back to... I tell you what, I'm still missing one person, I think. Let's have a look. 33, Joan. So... 33 is below number 40, and number 40 is Mavis Hoff. So
I couldn't tell it was a three, but that's one that ladies from Air Ministry.
So that's an Air Ministry lady.
Yes.
Okay, and let me just have another short. Have I got number 21? For some reason I've not wrote down number 21. Oh, that might have been one of those numbers that we thought...
I can't see 21.
Just remind me, I tell you who it might be, just remind me who is behind your sister. There's half a head behind your sister.
Is Betsy Matilda Hunter that was. Married Harold Allen. Auntie Betty.
Could be Matilda Hunter.
But it's Betsy Matilda, known as Betty.
Who married... Oh, that's she's...
Harold Allen's wife.
Oh, right, okay. Uncle Harold, so 41.
Yes.
Got you. Yeah. Right, let's go for 43 then. Where's 43?
42 is Desmond Woodward.
Have I put 42 down? Let's have a look. Desmond Woodward.
Yeah, 42. Now where's 42?
Oh, well, no, we might have run out.
Yes, I can't see 40.
42 is Desmond Woodward. Good. And it looks like, because I've got 39 and 40, let me check, I've got 39, who is Evelyn?
Allwood. And then 40 is Mavis. 41, Harold. 42, Desmond.
Right, okay. There is... I've made a mistake somewhere because 32... Yeah, okay. Have we got 38? Reg Durney.
Yeah.
Right, okay, I think we might have them all. I'll come back to you if not.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's...
So, on this picture here, I'm going to change pictures for the last few minutes. Because this is the, I think that's VJ Day, isn't it, on...
Kirk Street.
So can you, apart from you two, you can see you and your sister, can't you? Do you know anybody else?
Yes. There's Harold Morris, a boy with spectacles on next to...
Anybody else? If you just, I'm not going to write, I'm just going to take a mental note.
There's Raymond Quambra, Roy Green, Kenneth Suggett, boys. Yeah. There's Norma Green at the front, near the frontier in a black coat, and Georgina Taff. There's Beatrice Drayton, I can see. Oh, and there's Emily Hudson in a beret. She always wore this bow beret. And let's see here. There's Mrs. Isles. Oh, and there's Mrs. Crooks next to Mrs. Isles. She is... Oh dear, I didn't get her.
Well, if you just...
Somewhere in this area, a lady with glasses on.
Mrs. Crooks, who's Mrs. Crooks? Oh, that's...
George Crooks' wife, they were at number 9 Kirk Street.
George Crooks' is... So we might...
If you go up above the tier and on the table... in the second row, there's a smallish lady, that's Mrs. Isles, and then Mrs. Crooks is wearing spectacles.
Right, okay.
There's Doreen Parrott, who lived near the school, as well. There's Mr. and Mrs. Parkin here.
Yeah.
And there's Charlie Woodward. He's next to a lady who's got a baby in a high chair. Charlie Woodward. And there's the Mayor and Mayoress again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we know a few on there, so what I'll do with them, I'll work out who we can, how we can talk about them.
Yeah.
But just for the end of this video, Joan, you said you're on that picture at the bottom left.
Yeah.
Can you just tell me if there's more people that you can see on there who you know, is there?
Well, there should be Margaret Wilson. Well, Margaret Orange, who married the boy who's leaning over Desmond Wilson. And there was Rosemary, well, a married name's Moore. She went to the same school as Margaret Orange did. And she called it Carrollgate Council School. I don't know whereabouts it was.
So, on there then, You are definitely on there, you and your sister.
Next to Mary Wilcox, yeah.
Is there anyone else you're with on there who you recognise close by?
Well, there's Peggy and Betty Willie, the other twins. And it's her, it would be her sister-in-law who was Barbara Prince, must have married the brother David, because they called her Barbara Willie when she sent this photo in.
Right, okay.
To the town's office, yeah. Yeah.
And what day was that? Can you remember what that picture's showing?
Well, it was Thanksgiving week, when we all sang Jerusalem and This England and various songs we sang, which we'd been to the rehearsals at Sir Frederick Miller School, because the boys are there as well, you see.
Right, okay.
And we were sort of next to the boys.
But that was 1945.
Five, yes.
So is that your class? Is there like your class of school people there then? Who's there?
Yes, some of them and other schools as well, you see. It was the top classes, as I remember, of each school. Huh. Who'd been practising for a few weeks, singing, these songs.
As you talk about songs, just let me have that back so we don't get distracted. Let me have them both back, Joan, otherwise we'll be talking about them forever and I've got seconds left, minutes left. Do you think your sister had a favourite song when you were young? Can you remember?
No.
What about your mum? Can you remember any sort of favourite songs that anybody had?
Well, the first record we ever bought was one called Peg of My Heart. And it was on an old 78. And I think it was a yellow label on it.
How old would you have been? Was that as
when we first started work, that was.
Oh, probably when you were 14,
15. 15, yeah.
Mm. What was it called?
Peg O' My Heart. It was it was an American singer. Can't think of his name. It wasn't anybody who later on had remembered.
Why would you have bought that?
Because it was popular. There used to be radio programmes with, for the, what was the most bought record.
Yeah, charts.
Yeah, so it was tough.
Do you think, you might not remember, but do you think you was excited because you bought your first record?
Oh, yes. First one that we got a modern wind-up gramophone then. I bought it off Pat.
Oh, Pat next door.
Pat Askew.
Yeah, she lived next door.
Yeah. No, she didn't live next door to us.
Didn't she?
No.
Oh.
It was Pat Jackson who lived next door to us.
Didn't Pat Jackson live that way and Pat Askew live that way?
Yeah. Yes, that's it.
So she did live next door?
No, next door but one. It was Mrs. Norgut next door.
Oh, right. I didn't know that.
To begin with, yeah. She's on the
victory
photo.
It was Pat...
She's not on the... Pat Askew's not on the...
No, but it was Pat Askew who shouted captains.
Oh, yes, the horse. The horse
was in the garden. Mm-hmm. Right, I'm going to... We're finished.
Oh, right.
We've got to finish because...
It's cut off. Oh, dear.
It's not cut off yet.
It's your Irish heart I'm after, peg o' my heart. Your glances make my heart say, how's chances? Come be my own, come make your home in my heart. Lots of room for pain.